What is up, Tranny Star Galactican? My camera's doing really good things today. Look, I can do the robot. So, this week is again my question week, and I decided that we should talk about how sometimes, like, when people treat you, like, just because you're trans, they think that they can ask you, like, whatever they want to. You know, like, anything is, you know, alright for them to say. And it sometimes feels more like they're treating you like a science project or an exhibit than an actual human being. And that part sucks. But, just like, what are some of the more and lovely things that people have said to you and thought that it was okay to do? It's like, one of my personal favorites is always, like, oh, really? I would have never have guessed. Wow. And then they'll go on to say, so what was your name before? Like, what's that gonna, what's the point of knowing that if I'm not that person and that's not my name now? Like, what is that gonna reveal to you about me? Nothing. I hate it when people do that. Hate it, hate it, hate it! I also really think it's, funny when people just... I think it's funny and also very offensive. So it's a mix. But when people, just start talking about your genitals and just, like... So, you can... Do you have periods? Can you have periods? Do you... So, what does it look like? You know, like, they just start talking, like... And you kind of just want to be like... How is your left vaginal lip doing today? How is that? Is it copacetic? Is everything cool down there? You know? Because I just don't think that people really get it. Like, it's just like... You don't say that kind of thing to people. You just don't talk about that. I just don't understand why people think it's okay. Because of my gender identity is incongruent with my biological sex, you think that you can ask me about my penis and that I'm going to be cool with that. And sorry, but if you're not sucking it, or if you're not doing something to it, we're not talking about it. Sorry. When these situations come up, I usually, if I don't freeze up because I'm just so taken aback by the fact that you'd have the audacity to say such a thing like that to me, I will, I'll be very, political and nice and very diplomatic and just be like, actually, that's not something that I prefer to talk about because it's not something that I would ask you as a cisgendered person. Like, sometimes it'll be nice, if you catch me in a bad mood, I'll be like, what the fuck kind of question is that? How is your pussy doing? You know, like that, I'll say something really ugly and make an ass out of myself, like usual. Yeah. But then, you know, other times, people are well-intentioned, and they don't know that they're ignorant on these kind of issues, so they don't know that they're, that they could be being offensive. And generally, I'm very hard to offend in, like, an actual, fuck you, I'm offended kind of way. I'm pretty difficult to have that happen with. But I know a lot of people are more sensitive and a lot more asshole-ish than I am, which is difficult to think about someone being more of an asshole than I am, but I do try to be nice sometimes. Sometimes. And, yeah. So I always, I try to tell somebody because I know that I'm going to be a lot nicer to them probably than somebody else, some other jackass is going to be to them. I always try to let them know that that's not a cool thing to say. Yeah. And if it worst comes to worst, I just call them out and make them look like a total buffoon in public. Like, I look freaking smart, and they're just like, yeah. Pet peeves. What pisses me off, the thing that pisses me off the most lately, and I'm here to tell you, if you were one of these people, get the fuck off my friends list. Go ahead and do not watch, don't watch the rest of this video. Just go straight to hell. Go straight to hell and die. Okay. I am very, very irritated and annoyed with the queer people and the queer positive people that worship Jeffree Star, Johnny Boy, who else is a good one? Carson Kressley, and the guys from Queer Eye from the Straight Guy. Anyone like that, mostly Jeffree Star. Anyone like that, what the fuck? Why are you worshiping somebody like that? You know? What about Harvey Milk? What about Byron Rustin? You know? What about people that have fought and sometimes died for the rights that you have today and to further them? And you're worshiping a pink-haired twit who wears too much makeup. You can just take that makeup off. Blech. Yeah. So that's my personal thing. These queer idols that are not, like, doing anything for the community except for being like, I'm queer and fucking fabulous, and yeah. It's just like, oh my god, go suck a dick, because clearly that's the only thing that you're good at. Yeah, alright, well, it's been a wonderful Saturday. It's very warm here again. When I went home for spring break, it was blizzarding. And now it's very warm. It's like 80 degrees, so I'm going to go and walk around outside without a shirt on, because I can. Oh, and I'm getting on Accutane, just so you guys know. You won't have to look at this too much longer. Well, a couple more months, probably. But yep, I'm taking rocket fuel to get rid of my acne. Awesome.